Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and I am super excited to talk about one of my favorite things, muscle attachments. And there are quite a few terms associated with muscle attachments, and we want to differentiate these in order to be successful throughout the year and understand what we even mean by proximal attachment or distal attachment. Throughout the year, we will be asking you in lab and through dissection supplementary videos to identify bony landmarks. And some of these bumps and lumps are associated with certain structures attaching to the bone. So you may have heard the term ligaments. Ligaments are connective tissues that will attach bone to bone. Also importantly, tendons, which is where we'll spend some more of our time in this session, tendons are going to attach to bone as well. So in essence, tendons will connect muscle bellies to bone. So if a muscle belly contracts often and forcefully, this will pull on that bony attachment more and more, and it will create larger projections or processes. One bony attachment site we are learning today is the coracoid process, which I have outlined here in red. And this is on the anterior scapula, or your shoulder blade. And this will be the distal attachment site of the pectoralis minor muscle. The M right here means muscle. So this is one of the reasons we have you learn these bony landmarks. So you can kind of put the distal attachment site and match it with the proximal attachment site and understand a lot of important things about the muscle. So let's get into those muscle attachment sites. Understanding these sites, even the very basics as in which muscle, which bone a muscle attaches to, will give you information on two major things. First, it will help you understand which joint or joints that muscle crosses. And a muscle, and this is an important concept, so make sure to put a little star next to it. A muscle must cross a joint or pass over a joint to be directly involved with the action of that joint. So understanding, say for this biceps brachii, which is here, that the biceps brachii is crossing over the shoulder joint, due to the tendons here, as well as the elbow joint, and even the proximal radial ulnar joint, but mainly this elbow joint is kind of where it's at. So the fact that the tendon or the muscle belly cross over those joints means that that muscle can play a role there. Additionally, based on the location and attachment points of the muscle, this can give you some important clues regarding the action or the actions of that muscle without really having to memorize it. So one example in the upper limb is most muscles that are anteriorly placed are going to be flexor muscles, whereas most muscles posteriorly placed are extensor muscles. So that's just kind of an intro into that. We'll get more details into movements in other videos, but that will just kind of knowing basically where the muscle is, if you learn some overall rules, will help you understand what those muscles do. Now, one point regarding when we describe what actions a muscle can perform, you often see a list of actions. And say for this session, we're going to be learning about pectoralis major, which is kind of located here-ish, going this way. And so you'll see a list of actions that muscle can do. And the pectoralis major at the shoulder joint can abduct and medially rotate and some other actions, the shoulder joint. Don't worry, we'll talk about that in more detail in a mini video. But what I wanted to note is that the actions that are described in such lists are concentric contractions. And these are what occurs when a muscle shortens when contracting. So if you think the muscle shortens, it will pull on a bone in order to create an action. So it's typically what we think of with muscle contractions. Now, I do want to note here that muscles are certainly capable of lengthening or stretching as well. And these types of contractions are a very important part of fluid movements. But the actions of a muscle that you will be seeing throughout the year will be these concentric contractions. Okay, let's now discuss the pertinent terminology for these attachments. Proximal, sometimes you'll see superior, but more often you'll see proximal. Attachments are exactly what they sound like. They will be the proximalmost attachment of the muscle, or the attachment that is closer to the trunk. And you will see in this case here of the biceps brachii that there are actually two proximal attachments that are on the scapula. So these are closer to the trunk than, say, the distal attachment that's way down here on the radius. So these would be the proximal attachments. Traditionally, proximal attachments were called the origin sites, and you will definitely hear or see the term origin in other resources, and sometime in our own resources. They're kind of used interchangeably, but I'll talk about why there's been a transition away from that. These particular attachments are the ones that are typically fixed during major concentric contractions, meaning that during those movements, this bone is not moving. All right, these will be the immovable bone or the fixed bone. So, in one of the for biceps brachii, one of the major movements will be flexion of the forearm. Think the forearm bones are moving this way, moving up that way. And so, the distal attachment or the insertion site will be the movable bone toward the other attachment site. So, the distal attachment or the insertion are typically the when that muscle contracts and shortens will pull this bone up towards the proximal attachments. In this case, that'd be the radius, so the radius is moving more towards those proximal bones. You always need one immovable bone to allow more precise and safe movement on the other end. Now, these roles may reverse with certain muscles, and the proximal attachment would be the bone that moves, and the distal attachment is the bone that stabilizes. And that's why we've moved more to the descriptive proximal and distal attachments, because that's just descriptive of where the muscle's attaching, rather than origin and insertion, because these more traditional terms kind of pigeonhole the proximal end as always being immovable, or the distal end as always being movable, which we know is not always the case. So, this is plain more descriptive. If you hear the term proximal attachment, you know that that's the attachment site that's most proximal, whereas origin, not so much. So, you will be seeing these terms quite a bit as we talk about each individual muscle. Sometimes we'll get quite specific in terms of an exact bony structure. Sometimes it'll be more general as it just attaches to the radius or to the scapula. It's dependent on the specific muscle, but you will certainly be hearing those, so we wanted to introduce them here. All right, so for this session, we will begin our first few muscle attachment sites for a few select muscles like pectoralis major and minor, serratus anterior. But in this video, we are more describing what that terminology associated with muscle attachment sites mean. So this slide is a nice summary of some of those key terms, those kind of high yield terms that will keep coming back. And I recommend coming back to this for both studying, but also as a reference as you're getting used to navigating anatomy, which may take a little while, but eventually you will become a bit more comfortable with these terms. Thank you for your time and attention, and have a great rest of your day.